Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to use Blender. If today is your first time to use Blender, where to get a Blender? Just search at the search bar here. Download Blender. Enter. No internet, sorry. So after you search in Google, click the first link. And here you can download the installer. You have two choices. The first is the installer. After you download this, you install in your computer, in your Windows 10, you appear here. This is the installer. Another option is you can download the zip file. After that, you can unzip the zip file. It is portable, you can put it in your USB drive and bring it to anywhere and use it any computer, and even your own computer. For me, I always come here to download the latest version of Blender. Yeah, the latest version. I already installed. Just do some demo here. If this is your first time to open a Blender, and actually you can choose your own language. Your own languages is here, Edit, Preferences, Interface, and here you can choose your language. As demo, I will use English. English is an automatic one. English. So once you open the Blender, you can see this is the light. The light, the cube, and the camera. We will discuss the camera later. At first, for today, we focus on the cube and the line first. So in this cube, now you are in the object mode. Then, here you can add a mesh, for example, a plane. Now the plane is at here. Now the cube is here. If you want to move it, so now if I click the cube, select, the cube is selected. If I click the plane, then the plane is selected. So if I want to move the cube, now, this is the move. Click, the gizmo will be here, then you can move it. And what else? If you click the blue plane, you move around the X and Y axis. The X and Y plane, sorry. If Ctrl G to return to the previous action, and you can rotate. Rotate the blue color, XY plane, the green color, XZ plane, and the red color, YZ plane. So this is scale. You can scale in this axis. Scale in another axis, the X axis, and scale in Z axis. Okay. Rotation. Okay, this is the object mode. And the plane also do the same. Now you have the plane. Plane is a mesh. Cube is another mesh. The next I'm going to introduce the light to you. The light. Now I make this plane bigger. S is for scale. So now this is the light. First you need to be familiar with this. This is a wireframe mode. Then you only can see the wireframe. And this one is a solid mode. You can see all the solids without the color. And this one, this mode, the viewport shading, you can see all the colors, include the texture. Okay, this one I can change the cube color, and here. Okay. Not here, sorry. We don't discuss this first. Go on. We focus on the lighting first. For the first day you start to use the blender. If you click this, this is the render mode, viewport shading. Then you can see the lighting effect, all the shadow. And this is the light. You can move the light. See. Move it as an object. Move the light, it will change the shadow direction. Now I add one more object here. Add mesh. I add a cylinder. Okay. So what can you modify on the light? You can see. When the cube is selected, you don't have the bulb. When I select the light by clicking on the light, then you can see the green color light bulb here. You can do some changes on the setting of the light. The color, you can change the color of the light. By default, it is white color, the center. The power of the light now is 1000 watts. How about if I change to 10,000? It is much more brighter. And what else? This is the sunlight. Sunlight, you use 100. Here. The point. With 1. The strength of the sunlight. The whole map will have the sunlight. And you can change the direction of the sunlight. Click the light. This one you can change the direction. Select the light, then move the direction. The direction of the sunlight. And you can make it a spotlight also. Then change the direction of the spotlight. Of course this is 1 watt. 1 watt is not enough. You can change the power to become 1000 watts. Okay, this is the spotlight. You can change the direction of the spotlight. Also, you can change the size. This is 75 degree. How about if I change to 50? See, now it's a 50 degree. Then you can change the direction. You also can add a light here. Add a light here, add. Just click add. Then here you have light. Point. You have an extra point light here. How many watts at here? It's very weak, it's 10 watts. You make it become 1000. Enter. Then it is brighter. You created a point light here. If 100 watts. Is weaker, better let it be 500 watts. So here you can create any of the lighting effect. Now you have a spotlight. Then now this is a point light selected. I change the color, make it become green light. Can do a lot of lighting here. Now I also can add the sunlight. Sunlight, okay. Then you will make everything bright because of you already have a sunlight here. Now where is the location of the sunlight? It's here. Direction of the sunlight. You can drag the yellow spot. Okay. There's so much difference. The sunlight must point to the earth. So this shadow is caused by the spotlight, and this shadow is caused by the sunlight. And how about this shadow? The point light? Does the point light cause any shadow? Yes. These two shadow caused by the point light. Alright. So that's all about the light. So we just pause here, and the next video I'm going to share with you the edit mode and also modeling of the cube, all the meshes modeling. So see you in my next video.